Want to say blessed good morning.
Just lift your voice and say smile.
Can somebody smile on their face out there today? It's a beautiful praise and worship Wednesday.
Want
to say blessed good morning to Mini Me. Good God Almighty. Sister Erica. GGA. Mommy. Want to say bless, say good morning to Jesus Child. Jesus picked me all the way in Jamaica. JJ is in the house. Hey, Sister Erica, have I told you lately? I love you, sis. Hey, Jesus Child, have I told you lately? I love you, sis. From my family to your family, we love you. Wait, there's 247. Want to say blessed good morning to you. Hey, wait, it's 247. Can I tell you something? From my family to your family, I love you.
Better is one day.
Better is one day. It's a beautiful Wednesday. Can you wake up with a smile on your face today? Knowing that it's not what you're going through, but it's where you're going. Ah, good God Almighty. All you have to do is take a look at what you're going through, the magnitude of what you're going through, and you will know where you're going. If you ain't going through nothing, you ain't going nowhere. But the greater the battle, the greater the trials, the greater the tribulation, the greater the anointing that's upon your life, the greater the blessing, the greater the breakthrough. My God Almighty. And the more you're afflicted, the more you increase. For the more that Pharaoh and the Egyptians afflicted the children of Israel, the Bible said the more they grew, the more they were afflicted, the more they grew. Don't you realize something? I'm going to leave that alone. I'm going to be riding solo today. Shout out to my sidekick, my partner in Christ. I ain't going to say crime, because we ain't committing no crime. My partner in justice, because we're agents of the Lord. We're agents of heaven. We arrest every demon and give them not even life sentence. We arrest every demon and give them the death penalty. Death by the blood. Send them back to dry places where they belong. Forbid them to body hop. Forbid them to have any more function. Good God Almighty. Come on, text somebody, tweet somebody, MySpace, your space, our space, iPhone, your phone, our phone, everybody's phone, Facebook, inbox them, kick them, WhatsApp them, tell them it's time for praise and worship Wednesday on the Morning Glory program with your host, none other than you, your evangelist. Spread the word, invite somebody to join you for the ride. I've got a word for you. Last night I was sitting down talking to my sidekick. That's why I love hanging around her. See, you got to hang around people that when you and them begin to talk, you get revelation. Good God Almighty. Hey, Sister Erica, you got to hang around some folk that when you begin to talk to them, you get revelation. Hey, waiters, 247. You got to sit and talk with some folk that when you begin to talk to them, you get revelation. In Jesus' child. You got to start hanging around folk that when you talk to them, you get a revelation. And as we began to talk last night at work, we realized it's not the going out, it's not the going into a situation. It's not the going in, but it's the coming out. Somebody better type in the chat room, better high five themselves and tell somebody it's not the going in, but it's the coming out. Ah, good God Almighty. Y'all feel me yet? Everybody live. Can somebody smile this morning? Hallelujah. Just put a hold to it. Lift your voice and say, oh,
let me make you smile. Lift your voice and say, oh, 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 let me make you smile. Come on, get richer with it. Everybody just say it.
My God, I want to say good morning all the way down to Moscow, Atlanta, Georgia, Jamaica, New York, New York. Somebody say, I want to make you smile. I want to make you smile. My God.
Lift your voice to the Lord in this moment, every worshiper, and say something to the Lord.
I want to make you smile this morning. I want to lift your voice and say, Lord God, we just want to make you smile. My God. I want to say, bless, say good morning all the way. West Palm Beach, WPB. My big uncle, Uncle Fireball Henry, man, dropped a word last night. I was at work. I couldn't move. I was walking on the floor with my wireless headset. I couldn't get him out my ears. Usually, I'll leave the phone and go help my people, but I was helping them while he ministering in my ears. I was like, nah, man, I got to stay connected to Fireball Uncle Henry right now because he's dropping a word. Good God Almighty. Revival continues on Shabbat Radio with my big brother DJ Penny. Restoration. My God, my God, my God. You got to join him. Shabbat Radio streaming through ATL Praise House also. DJ Robert Ministry. The word has been awesome so far. Revival week. Want to say good morning to Canada? Oh, Canada. Oh, Canada. Hey, Sister Erica, you getting your passport? Hey, listen, let me tell you something. I gotta stop the music for this one. Want to say good morning to those who are always following me and, you know, streaming and, you know, following me on YouTube. Good morning, YouTube world. Amen, somebody. You know, if you miss the program, or even if you've enjoyed a program and you want to hear it again, you can always go to my YouTube channel. Amen, somebody. And you can find the programs there. If you don't know how to find it, just go on my Facebook page and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And then you'll see all the programs listed there. But back to you, Sister Erica. Let me tell you something. Let me give you a warning. Forewarning, pre-warning. Amen. Listen, it's now February. You have March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October. You have all those months to prepare. But I want to see you in Canada in November for Empowered to Win. Right, Sister Yvonne? Where's Denden? Denden not on. Denden probably at work. Denise Myers probably at work. Right, Sister Yvonne. Right, cuz. We want to see you, Sister Erica, in Canada. You know, you remember a while back I was envisioning and saying, you know, it would be good to have and see, you know, all of the Morning Glory, you know, listeners, those that have partnered and supported me and been here on this journey with me over the years. We've had a long journey. We've had a long journey. You know, we've come a long way, mighty long way. We've been some rough times, some ups and downs. Y'all been through it with me. And, you know, I just want to say I love each and every one of you and appreciate you, because you could have abandoned ship and leave me and said, boy, this man, you don't know what he's doing. But I'm glad that you understand that many are the afflictions of the righteous. There are seasons that we go through. Sometimes we got to pull back and go hide in the closet. And then the Lord will bring us back forth. But you know, it's always good to take some time off, because sometimes you even get burnt out. Amen, somebody. And with you all that love to pull and draw and, you know, pull out of people, you want me to be in here all sometimes the whole week. Amen. But listen, I'm grateful for each and every one of you. Amen, somebody. I'm grateful for you. But you remember when I envisioned that it would be good to have all of the Morning Glory people in one place and just having a worship feast, having a wonderful time. Well, guess what? We have that opportunity. And November, Canada, November. I'll tell you more about it. Amen. So, Sister Erica, you better get mommy. I'm going to have to talk to mommy myself about this one. Because I'm going to tell mommy, you need to talk to her. Start saving. My God. Somebody say it's already getting better.
It's already getting easier. When you prophesy to your neighbor, tell them God's already moving on your behalf. Song just says,
it's already getting better. It's already
getting easier. God's already moving on your behalf. Y'all sing, children.
It's already getting better. It's already
getting easier. God's already moving on.
For me.
He did it for me.
Somebody say he did it for me. Oh yes, he did. Oh yes, he did. He did it. Yes, God did it. It's already getting better. It's already
getting easier.
God's already moving on my behalf. In other words, he heard your prayer. He heard your cry. And he's moving on your behalf. He's preparing a word. He's preparing a word of deliverance, of emancipation. He's preparing a word to set you free. He's preparing a song to deliver you, to minister to you, to set you free. Because he's going to do it for you. Not just to benefit you, but to benefit him. Because his name is calling, is on your life. His purpose is on your life. And whatever God declares over your life, his word will not return unto him void. But it must accomplish that which it pleased it. That which it was sent to accomplish, it must be accomplished. And God is not a man that he would lie, nor the son of man that he would, oh God, repent. But if God said it, he means it, and it has to come to pass. So him doing what he's got to do is not just to benefit you, but this one is on him. Oh, good God Almighty, somebody better help me. I want to love God. He did it.
Yes, God did it.
And it's already
getting better.
It's already. Want to say blessed good morning all the way to the Cayman Islands, Sister Samuels. My nephew DJ Robert Samuels. Want to say blessed good morning to you, the Samuels family. Hey, Sister Samuels, can I play this song for you right here? Oh, God, I feel. Yes. Mandoroko Smaya Dabaha. Listen, I'm in a scary zone right now. I don't know what's about to happen, but something finna happen. I feel something in the atmosphere. There is something brewing in the atmosphere. Somebody, I just came on. I just started this program, but somebody's already pulling on the anointing, on the spirit. I can feel it. I can sense it. There's something happening in the atmosphere. My God. Something is happening in the atmosphere. And I'm telling you this morning, take the limits off. Take doubt and fear off. Because it's already. I said it's already. Want to say blessed good morning to my sister and friend. Family. She ain't sister no more. She family now. Georgetown.
Getting better. It's already getting easier. God's
already. Barbados. My Bajan family is here, y'all.
Listen, I want you to say,
hey, Terry family. Somebody say,
he did it for
me.
Yes, he did. He did it for me.
Want to say good morning, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Somebody say he did it for me. Somebody say he did it.
Just for me. Sing it again. God did it.
I feel something in the atmosphere.
Getting better. It's
already
getting easier.
God's already. Already
getting easier.
God's already
moving on my behalf.
Jesus, my God, he did it. He did it. What did he do? Can somebody say he turned it around? He turned it around for me.
But not defeated.
My God. Want to say, let's say good morning to all the partnering stations of Hope for Life Radio, Action Radio, Kingdom Link, Pastor Clark and the Night Night Machine and the crew, Uncle Fireball, Deacon Henry, Prosperity FM, Brother Devin Ministry, BDM, DJ Robert Ministry in the Cayman Island, PWE Ministry, Brother Steve, Sister Price and the team, Big Brother DJ Penny Shabak Radio, True Gospel Radio, Love 316 in the UK. Want to say good morning to my beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. She ain't sister no more. She family now. She family. But I want to say good morning, Prophet Nadia. It's Glory Carrier. For me. Hallelujah.
Around for me.
And I bless say good morning to 98.1 FM in the Boogie Down Bronx, 92.1 FM Brooklyn, and of course 101.7 FM in the Cayman Island, Kennesaw. Somebody say around for me. Somebody say around for me.
Around for me.
It's turning. I don't know about you, my God, but there's something. I sense something in this atmosphere right now. I want you to prophesy to somebody in the chat room. Just type their name and say, God's turning it around for you.
If I stay strong.
If I stay strong,
there's no reason to doubt.
Reason to doubt.
I know he's working it out.
Know he's working it out.
And it's turning around.
It's turning around for me.
This is the good news.
And it won't always be like this. My God.
That concerning him.
Somebody say,
and sooner or later,
it'll turn in your favor. Shout it,
it's gonna turn in my favor.
It's turning around.
It's turning around.
Won't always be like this.
The Lord will perfect
what concerning me. And sooner or later,
turn in my favor.
Sooner or later. Hey, can you just find a name in the chat room and just type their name and prophesy to them and said, listen, it's about to turn around for you. Somebody say, turning around
sometimes, discouraged.
Sometimes we get discouraged,
but not defeated.
But never defeated.
Cast down, but
we get cast down.
Not destroyed.
But not destroyed.
There are times.
There's times
don't understand.
That I can't comprehend. I can't understand what God is doing and the things that are going on. But I just believe that He's fixing to turn it around for me. Waiters, it's about to turn around for you. Letty, it's about to turn around for you. Sister Erica, Jesus Child, Terry Ann, it's about to turn around for you. Sister Yvonne, it's about to turn around.
Let me down. But I still believe it's turning around for me. Around for me. Around for me. Around for me. It's turning around for me. Around for me.
Can you just say it into the atmosphere?
Around for me. Around for me.
It's turning around.
Turning around for me.
Cause I can see the breaking.
I can see the breaking of day.
God is
making a way. A change is coming for me.
If I stay strong.
If I stand strong and believe.
There's no reason to doubt.
Blessed, good morning. You're live on the air.
Hi, good morning. Good morning.
Blessed, good morning, sis. What's going on? How are you?
I'm good. I want you to play, I Can Feel His Presence in This Place.
I Can Feel His Presence in This Place?
Yeah. And I Can Feel His Story.
You know who sings it?
Why? You played last time.
I played it last week?
Yeah.
Okay, alright. I'll find it for you.
Alright.
Alright, love you, sis.
Alright.
Alright, bless. Somebody say,
it's turning around.
Turning around. Be like this.
The Lord will perfect
what
concerning me.
And sooner or later, turn in your favor. Sooner or later. Somebody say, sooner or later. I tell you, somebody is in my spirit this morning. Somebody is pulling on me this morning. Somebody's pulling on me this morning. But may I just encourage you and tell you this morning that it's gonna turn around for you. It's fixing. God is fixing to turn it around for you. I don't know who I'm talking to. I don't know who I'm ministering to. But I just want to tell you this morning. I left work last night with a word. Hallelujah. I went to bed. I couldn't sleep well. Got up this morning. Back at it again. Because God wants to tell somebody today. In spite of all that you're going through. In spite of all that you've been through. God said to tell you, I've heard your cry. I've heard your prayers. And I've sent. Oh my God. My God. My
felt so alone. Some of my friends, they let me down. But I still believe it's turning around for me.
Oh, my God, my God.
Around for me. Around for me, it's turning around for me.
My God, Sister Samuels, you just brought tears to my eyes. You just brought tears to my eyes, Sister Samuels. That listen, you need to copy all of that right there. and just post it on my page. Because listen, I believe in the power of prayer, and when we pray, I believe that things has to happen. It's no doubt in my mind. I'm not praying amidst. The Bible said the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous avails much. And if we're praying and things ain't happening, it's time for us to just shut it down. But I believe in the power of prayer. And when we pray, I believe God is going to turn it around, whatever the situation is. Oh, good God Almighty.
And it won't always be like this. He will perfect that concerning him. And sooner or later, it'll turn in my favor.
Turning around,
for me.
It won't always be like this. The Lord will perfect that concerning him.
And sooner or later, it'll turn in your favor. Sooner or later,
turn in my favor.
Somebody say, sooner or later,
it's turning around for me. It's turning around.
That just lift your hands to the atmosphere and claim your season of turnaround. Hallelujah. Now let's say this together. Come on.
Around for me.
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 It's turning around.
Can I tell somebody it's turning, it's turning, it's turning, it's turning, it's turning. Ah. Mandedo seka rabasete keboshi andarara mahande kioro robosai. Robosendaba korea sekenda riviasai. Ha, Jesus. Ah.
We'll perform concerning you. Sooner or later,
it's gonna turn in your favor, Sister Erica, sooner or later. See, we don't know what time, we don't know what day, we don't know what hour, but we know that it's gonna turn around. We know without a shadow of a doubt that God has to perform what concerned him. And I don't know when and I don't know how, but I know he's gonna come through. He's gonna come through. Somebody says sooner or later. Sooner. Mando robo se kere de yandoro robo si karada da baha. Sooner. Somebody said sooner. Sooner or later. I feel a need to go into prayer right now. I feel a need to just go into prayer right now. So just indulge me right now. Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah.
God, we worship you in
hallelujah.
That you have created.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Something is stirring in my spirit right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
We thank you, God, that we are
hallelujah, hallelujah.
Fully made. We thank you, God.
I'm coming back to that song. I promise you. I got to play that song one more time. But right now, if you just indulge me, if you just open up your spirit right now to receive. I feel a sense of intercession right now. I feel, you see, you got to understand how this program operates. I don't operate by a set program or set way. This program is subject to a shift by the Holy Spirit. And when the Holy Spirit says shift, I shift with him. Because this is not my program. This belongs to the Lord. I'm just a vessel being used. And if he shifts me into another gear, it's like when you're in a car. My God, my car.
Father, we thank you for what you have given to us even now. Thank you, God, that right now
that car is just there to be used. And the car can't tell you whether it wants to go forward or backward. When you shift gear and say drive, the car must drive. When you say reverse, it must reverse. When you put it in park, it must park. And that's how, oh God, I am to the Holy Spirit. Ah, my shake.
We will serve the Lord. Oh God, wherever they are, Jesus, I send the power of the Holy Spirit to begin right now to arrest.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. And I declare right now, according to Isaiah 61, verses 1 to 3, that the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. Because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all that mourn and to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called the trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, your only begotten Son, and our soon coming King, the one that sits at the right hand, making intercession for us right now, the one that only through him can we get access to you, because no one goeth unto the Father or cometh unto the Father but through the Son. Oh God, so in the name of Jesus Christ, I prophetically speak these words into the atmosphere and upon my life and my family and territory, and I believe God for the manifestation of his power upon each and every person that is listening at the sound of my voice this morning. I declare and decree in the name of Jesus. Lord, your word declares that it's not by might, not by power, but by your spirit. So it's by the spirit of the living God. So as I pray, I believe the Holy Ghost is enforcing my decrees according to the will of God. Because let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. I therefore release my my faith in God and claim our victory in the name of Jesus, in the mighty, most powerful, wonder working name of Jesus. Let the words that I speak be prophetically loaded and launched as Holy Ghost missiles into any and every area of our life that requires Holy Ghost fire, explosion, and disintegration of demonic deposits and debris and poison. In other words, God, whatever has been in our system, whatever sin, whatever lust, whatever fornication, adultery, lying, cheating, whatever deception, whatever malice, unforgiveness, Lord God, anything that belongs to the enemy right now, anything that the devil can claim that belongs to him that he sees in us, I declare and decree by the Holy Ghost fire that it be disintegrated, burnt at root out, uprooted, oh God, destroyed permanently in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, oh Lord, because you are our beginning and our end. We start our day strong and we end our day triumphant with you by our side. I double dose our intellect and faculties with your word and inject into our memory every single bit of refreshment. In other words, refreshment, refreshing. The Hebrew word for that is napash. Every single bit of napash that your word provides, I charge the atmosphere with your glory and dissolve every dirty and filthy thoughts projected against our mind. I pull down every evil imagination that stands against the knowledge of Christ, and I destroy the works of the devil over our mind, spirit, our soul, our body, by your blood, Lord Jesus, by your word, your fire, and your anointing upon our life. Right now, God, I prophetically claim these words, and I speak them over our lives, over my household, over our loved ones. Now let the heavens bear us witness, and let the earth hear and respond to the words that we speak into the atmosphere even now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I declare and decree that we are unresponsive to demonic manipulation. I declare and decree that we are unresponsive, oh God, to demonic oppression. I declare and decree that we are unresponsive to demonic suppression. I declare and decree that we are unresponsive to every attack of the devil. I declare and decree that we're not just conquerors, but we are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus our Lord. So Father God, I declare and decree that we refuse today to be defeated, to be intimidated, to be manipulated. I have the mind of Christ. We have the mind of Christ. Our family has the mind of Christ. And we love God with all our heart. We are a terror to the enemy and his cohorts. We are strong. We are rich in every aspect of the term. We are patient. We are kind. We have the nature of Christ in us. Oh my God, let this mind be in us, which was also in Christ Jesus. For your word declares you will keep us in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you. So this morning, oh God, in the name of Jesus, we channel our mind to the word, to the heavens right now, and we declare there'll be no limitation, there'll be no blockage in the atmosphere. We come against every we come against every Jezebel spirit, every spirit of manipulation that will block our prayers. We come against the prince of Persia, and we ask you to release Michael and some archangel, some warring angel with flaming sword to war on our behalf. We declare war against the camp of the enemy. No more depression, no more oppression, no more suicide, no more sickness, no more hypertension, no more stroke, no more lupus, no more glaucoma. I declare and decree that there be healing in the name of Jesus, healing our family, healing our children, oh God.
healing concerning everything that pertaining to our destiny and our future. Hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord. So we thank you, Lord God, for filling our day with your presence, your glory, and your fire in our life. In the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, we arise to establish our legal right and dominion over this region and over every territory which you have given us jurisdictional authority. Ah, God. So every area, God, that you know that you'll be sending us to minister to your word, minister your word to your people, we take authority over those regions right now, over the region of Barbados, over the region of the Cayman Islands, Jamaica, Canada, throughout the US of A. Lord God, we take authority over every region in which you will be sending us to. Oh, Mandara Basanda, and we bind up every strong forces in those areas in the name of Jesus. According to Daniel 9:4, you are the only great and dreadful God, keeping the covenant and mercy to them that love you, even to them that keep your commandment. Oh God, so I appeal to the God who said in 2 Chronicles 7:13-16, if I shut up heaven that there be no rain, and if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sins and I will heal their land. Now mine eyes shall be open and my ears shall attend unto their prayer. Hear our prayer this morning, God, and attend unto our earnest need. Hearken unto the voice of our supplication. For Lord, in the morning we cry unto you. We are crying unto you right now. ATL Praise House is crying unto you. Hope for Life Radio crying unto you. Action Radio crying unto you. Kingdom Link Prosperity FM crying unto you. BDM Ministry and DJ Rubber Ministry crying unto you. PWE Ministry and Shabbat Radio crying unto you. True Gospel crying unto you. ATL Praise House crying unto you. We cry unto you. Almighty God, we cry unto you. We cry unto you. We cry unto you now, God. We cry unto you. We cry unto you, God. Lord, we cry unto you. We cry unto you. Oh, Mandaribosanderebosai. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We declare and we decree, Lord God, that we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation. We are set apart, and our hearts and eyes shall be perpetually there. We declare and decree that this place, this studio, your house, your job, hallelujah, is sanctified. We present our bodies as a living sacrifice by the shed blood of Jesus, our Savior, my God, and our Redeemer. Make these prayers holy and acceptable unto you. We confess our sins and the sins of our fathers. Let grace and mercy prevail over us. We declare, I am a son, that we have free passage for our prayer to ascend into the realm of the supernatural and will not be earthbound. We come into agreement with the Supreme Court of Heaven. And I am seated, hallelujah, in heavenly places with Christ Jesus, far above principalities. Therefore, war from this plane and realm, hallelujah, shall be successful. In the name of Jesus, we declare that the anointing of God breaks every yoke, open every portal, and assign angels to reinforce us as we advance into new levels, new dimensions, new realms, and new territories. Let there be a breakthrough in the heavens. We tap into the apostolic and prophetic veins. We shatter glass ceilings and smash spiritual bars and iron membranes. We declare and decree breakthrough in the atmosphere is established. We recalibrate the spiritual climate and and decree that every bit of lukewarmness must be replaced with the fire and the zeal of God. Baptize us with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Let there be fire in our mouth. And fire on our hands, fire on our feet, in the name of Jesus. We take authority over every demonic and satanic atmosphere and climates created by cultic activity, destiny altering images, incantations, ill spoken words, witchcraft, hostile environments, fear, terrorism, rituals, hatred, ethnic hatred, and violence. In the name of Jesus, I command that the spiritual climate shift, economical climate shift, social climate shift, cultural climate shift, educational climate shift, political climate shift, ecclesiastical climate shift. We command that the atmosphere must be filled with the glory of God. So we ask you, fill the atmosphere now, God. Fill this atmosphere now with your glory. Fill this room with your glory. Fill your people's presence with your glory. Lord, let your glory go before us. Just like Moses said, if your glory don't go before us, we will not move from this place. So Lord, show us your glory. Show us your power. Show us your strength. Lord, as we advance, as we humble, as we seek you, as we cry out to you, hear our cry, God, and answer. Heal your people right now. Let doors be open for your people right now. Let opportunity and entrepreneurship come to your people right now. Give them business ideas that will transform their financial situation. Oh, Masendo Koryabasanda, Lord, I prophesy to every pancreas that it will secrete the right amount of insulin, and our bodies will be conducive to healing. Heal be healed. Tumors be healed. Cancer be healed. Everything that is afflicting your people via infirmity, by your shed blood, we declare healing right now in the name of Jesus. Ah, yeah, no, 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 boss.
We have something new and something fresh in our lives as we continue to abide by your word. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I shall not sin against you. Father, we thank you for what you have given to us even now. Thank you, God, that right now our homes are becoming sanctuaries and holy places unto you. Thank you, God, that every single family member is being brought into the ark of safety. And we declare, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Oh, God, wherever they are, Jesus, I send the power of the Holy Spirit to begin right now to arrest them where they are. Father, in homes we speak and release the peace of God. We bind tension. We bind arguments. We bind disagreements. We bind the tragic circumstances. Even in the times of discomfort,
my
we release the peace of God. The peace of God that
becomes all
understanding. And we declare,
we come against every spirit of Balaam and Balak. We come against every fear of spirit, every Absalom spirit, every Korah spirit, every Jezebel spirit. We declare victory in the atmosphere, victory over Apostle Swaby and Prophetess Jacqueline Swaby and New Bethel, victory. Repastaba kuriamate kebiasa. Reba kundorobosi anarabahandai. Empty us of every impurity, God, from secret sins and carnal weakness. Empty us this morning. Let there be nothing in us, God, that will prevent your glory, that will prevent miracles from happening from us. Because you can't pour fresh oil, clean oil, clean
clean wine into a dirty vessel. So empty us, God, from every secret sin, every carnal weakness.
The curse of the law having become a curse for us. For Jesus bore sin in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sin, might live for righteousness. By whose stripes we declare healing to every mind, healing to every soul, healing to everybody. God, we bind the spirit of infirmity. We bind every disease and every sickness, everything that has rooted itself in our bodies. We curse it right now, and we declare that it is on the cross. And we arise in the newness of life, for he was wounded for our transgressions.
There's a miracle in the atmosphere. There's a miracle in the atmosphere.
And we declare with the stripes, we speak healing right now. We command in the name of Jesus, every decay and every defilement and every corruption, it must go in the name of Jesus. And we speak resurrection life. Things that are dying, things that may seem dead, we speak life. We speak resurrection life. We speak Jesus life. And Father, we continue to worship you. Every tormenting spirit, every spirit of oppression, every spirit of depression, we break every spirit of anxiety and stress, and we release the peace of God. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. And we declare right now that no weapon that is formed against us, no evil shall come nigh your dwelling, that none of us shall prosper in the name of Jesus. And Father, we release the Holy Ghost. Fill us afresh. Fill us afresh to be committed. Fill us afresh to do your work. Fill us afresh, oh God, to have a love and a fervor for you that we have never felt before. Now, Holy Spirit, arise, as the Son of God will rise with healing in his wings. God, we worship you today. We thank you for healed bodies. We thank you for minds that are functioning. We thank you for families that are in unity. We thank you, oh God, that we're blessed coming in and coming out. We thank you, oh God, that our bodies are totally whole in the name of Jesus. We thank you that our family members and those connected to us will function as one unit according to the word and the counsel of God. And Father, right now we lift up holy hands, and right now I release a fresh anointing of the Holy Ghost and fire. Let the presence of God, let the presence of God infiltrate and emanate and infuse the very atmosphere. We thank you for what you're doing. We thank you, blessed Holy Spirit.
Somebody say, we thank you,
Rabbi. That every empty part of us, you are filling to overflowing. And God, we receive it right where you are. Lift up your hands and receive the blessing of the Lord that makes
you
receive the peace of God.
I say unto you today,
that we are gathered in this most sacred place, Because we understand that the prayers of the righteous
are
the Bible declares that we're two or three gather together in his name, touching and agreeing. God says that he will be there in the midst. And even as we come into agreement,
Jesus,
even as you
Jesus, Jesus,
even as you have entered into the presence of the
See, I told you when I got into the studio this morning, I felt there's something in the atmosphere. The glory of God. The glory of God. It's not about the playing of music or the nice, comforting words, but it's about the glory and the presence of God and what God wants to do. We don't go by feeling, but we go by the move of God. When the Holy Spirit shifts, we shift with it. And there's a shift in the atmosphere.
And
God would always show up in a form and a fashion and a manner like this because somebody is in our shadow. God shows up because there's a need. The glory shows up because there's a need. There's a need. There's a need. And I don't know who it is that you've got a need this morning, but may I just say to you that your God shall supply. According to Philippians 3:19, he shall supply all your needs according to his riches. Somebody better just open your mouth right now and just holler hallelujah. Just holler thank you Jesus. Just shout. Just worship him right now.
That we should love you with all of our heart, all of our soul, and all of our
We adore you Lord. We lift you up, Lord. We magnify you. We declare and decree that you are King, that you are Lord, that you are Master, you are Savior, you are Ruler, you are our God.
We love you. We love you. We love you. We love you. So we declare it according to Deuteronomy
16,
as your servant Moses commands, that we love you now, that we love you today. And because we love you, we walk in your wills.
We walk in your will. We walk in your way.
We keep your commandments.
We walk in your way and in your presence, Lord.
For
in your presence is the fullness of joy, and at your right hand there are pleasures. There are pleasures.
And the proof that we love you is that we will walk according to your will.
We walk according to your will, Lord.
For we know that all things will work together.
We know all things working together for
the good of them that love the Lord and are called.
To them that are called according to the purpose and the will of God.
Father, we thank you for deep roots.
Lord, we thank you, we thank you.
We thank you for love that won't fail.
Lord, we thank you, we thank you. We
thank you for love. That won't
change. We thank you.
In the midst of the storm. Come on, saint of God, declare it again. God, I love you.
We love you.
God, I love you. And while I was yet a sinner,
we love you, you died for us.
You sent your son to die on the old rugged cross.
Lord, you died on our behalf.
While I was yet a sinner, you sent your only son to hang on the old cut down tree. So Father, I declare today that I love you back. I love you back. Come on, wherever you are, just declare it now. I love you back. God, I appreciate the expression of your love. God, I appreciate the realness of your love. God, I appreciate the depth of your love. God, I appreciate the deepness of your love.
Prophet is not here. He loves you more than you can ever imagine. Beyond your comprehension, he loves you. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you.
Love you. Love you. Love you.
He loves you. He loves you. He loves you.
Oh,
even as the waves of your glory sweep across this room.
Let it sweep across this room, oh God.
Your love is so powerful.
Let it sweep across. Move, Holy Spirit. Have your way.
God, I pray that my love will touch your love.
Lord, we pray that you have your way. Ah.
That even as our two loves touch, your heart and my heart, your heart in my heart, God, I pray that the manifestation of that love would be expressed even to others. For our love for you higher than deeper than the lowest valley.
Mandoroboshi, Mahandoroboshi.
Wider than the desert. That's how deep my love for you is, Lord.
Jesus.
There is none like you. Edo Shakti.
There is none.
There is none.
Somebody say, there is none.
You're the greatest lover that I've ever known.
Somebody just say, there is none. There is none. We lift up your name because there is none like you, Lord.
So I express my love for you.
Mande korababasai. No one can look at us when we were in our deepest, deepest, deepest muck and care for us like you can. You know, oh my God, my God, my God. You never saw our condition, but you saw our potential.
Even as you make
Jesus. And so we thank you.
Even as you commit to God, God commits to you.
We thank you.
And saint of God, that's why.
We thank you.
There will be no lack in your life. Because your life.
Can somebody lift your hand and say, I declare and decree that there'll be no more lack in my life. Come on, this is the kind of atmosphere where you are able, you're free, you got liberty to make prophetic declaration because death and life lies in the power of your tongue. And too often we've been fearful to say things because we don't believe that it can happen for us. But oh God, he said, he that cometh unto me must believe that I am a rewarder to them that diligently seek me. Oh my God, it's without faith, it's impossible to please God.
For even as we commit to you, even in this most sacred moment,
Jesus,
we declare that every,
just open your mouth right now, and whatever you need
is met in you.
Whatever you need, there's a special need. There's a special thing that you need. And I declare in this atmosphere, just open up your mouth and just make that declaration right now. Your Jehovah Jireh is here. Your provider, your provider, your provider is here.
Come on, let your voice be heard.
Every generational lack, every generational curse, we come against it now. We plead the blood against it now. We destroy it while Holy Ghost fire right now and declare that there'll be no more lack in our lives. We declare no more lack, no more lack. We come against the spirit of lack and poverty.
Emotional, those that are physical, those that are social, you meet every one of my needs. You meet every one of my needs. There's not a need that's not covered by you. Come on, saint of God, confess it now. By faith, confess it now. So we declare, Philippians chapter 4, verse 19, but my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches in glory. I declare that every need is met according to your riches in glory. Come on, open your mouth and declare it now as we pray this prayer of provision. Is met. I believe it. I believe it. I believe it. Come on. Speak it on yourself right now. Wake up. Wake up and speak it on yourself right now. Declare it over your house. Declare it over your bank account. Declare it over your body. That every one of your needs are met in Jesus' name. Declare it now. That your cupboards are full. That your garages are full. We can confess it by faith. According to 2 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 10, which declares, he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will also supply and increase our store of seed, and that you will also enlarge the harvest of our righteousness. Oh, Father, we
hallelujah.
Thank you for enlargement right now.
Hallelujah.
God, we thank you. We thank you for enlargement.
Hallelujah. Not just the right job, Sister Erica, but the right opportunity to do the right business idea, the right entrepreneurship.
Enlarge
your territory.
Enlarge my 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 territory. Oh, this is a good spot to give Jesus. Him praise.
Jesus.
This is a good spot to give him praise. This is a good
spot to give him praise. Hallelujah. Somebody worship him. Somebody worship him. Somebody worship him. Somebody worship him. I told you from the beginning of the program that something is in the atmosphere. There's a pull on my spirit. We declare and we decree, we declare and we decree. Oh God, your will be done for your people today. We come against every generational curse and hindrances that have been passed down from generation to generation.
Go ahead and just convince yourself he's good.
Jesus. Jesus. Can you just, I'm not in any rush. I'm not in any hurry. If you're not able to discern and sense the spirit and the move of the Holy Ghost, the spirit of the Lord has come to set somebody free, to set your the course of your destiny on track.
Creation, Father of heaven and earth, we come to you now in the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus, the name at which every
somebody
knee shall bow and every tongue
Jesus.
Shall confess. I come to you now, knowing that in your name there is power. Knowing that in your name there is deliverance.
There's deliverance.
Knowing that in your name there is freedom.
There's freedom.
I bring to you now every generational curse and every generational pattern of dysfunction and behavior.
Yes.
That the enemy has tried to perpetuate.
Yes.
Through family bloodline.
Yes.
I bind the hand of the enemy and I curse them back to hell. And I decree that there will be a release of God's healing power.
Yes.
Of God's delivering power.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, first of all, I come before you asking that physical legacies be broken.
Yes, God.
God, that infirmity that is passed through families, health problems that have run in generations, I decree now that there will be a release of generational blessing for healing. I come against high blood pressure. I come against glaucoma. I come against sugar diabetes. I come against strokes. I come against lupus. I come against sickle cell. I come against Parkinson's disease. I come against Alzheimer's. I come against every inherited, every passed down infirmity.
Yes, Lord.
I bind it in the name,
of Jesus. We bind it.
The 39 stripes that you took on your back.
Yes.
Shall be for a release of generational healing.
Yes.
Father, I decree that these infirmities shall not visit the next generation.
No, Lord. Hallelujah.
I decree that there will be a healing. That there
healing,
will be a
Lord.
Of the curse.
Yes.
That the cycle will be broken in the
right
name
now, God.
Every name, the name of Jesus.
Right now, God.
Lord, I lift it up to you now, and I decree that there will be a touch. There
yes.
There will be a move.
Yes.
There will be a healing. There will be a deliverance in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
I decree it now and I call it done. I decree that healing. I decree that anointing.
Yes.
That destroys that physical legacy that is passed down through bloodlines.
God.
I bind it in Jesus' name. And
yes,
I
Lord.
The healing power. Lord, I thank you that bodies are being healed.
Yes, Lord.
That even babies who are still in the womb, who would ordinarily come out suffering, I decree that they are healed now.
Right now,
and that
Lord.
They will be born healthy and future generations.
Yes,
shall
Lord.
Come forth, and there shall be no sign, no sign,
no
of the
defects.
Generational curse that has been in previous generations. I speak this into the realm of the Spirit, and I decree that there will be a release of that generational blessing now. In the name of Jesus, I destroy physical legacies that have been a curse. And I release the generational blessing of physical restoration in Jesus' name. In
Hallelujah.
Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Somebody say, in Jesus' name. Somebody say, in Jesus' name.
I love you.
Somebody say, I love you.
Again. Now, Lord, I lift up to
you.
I lift up to you every spiritual legacy, every generational curse of spiritual legacy that has been passed down. I come against witchcraft. I come against sorcery. I come against those that have dealt with psychics and those who have worked with witchcraft. I bind the powers of hell that have tried to bring a curse in the mind, that have come against the image of self-esteem. I bind the hand of the enemy. I come against the legacy of every relative that has dealt with horoscopes, that has dealt with Ouija boards, that's dealt with any kind of unclean idolatry, and I bind it in the name of Jesus. I take authority.
Yes, Lord.
The spirit of fear.
Yes.
I take authority over the spirit of inadequacy.
Yes.
I take authority over the spirit of condemnation.
Yes.
And I decree that there will be a release now in the
name of Lord.
Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
That which I bind on earth is
in the name of Jesus.
That which I loose in the earth is loose. In the heavens.
Yes, Lord.
I decree that there will be a release of the anointing in the realm of the spirit. God, that your people will not be bound by the transgressions.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
God, you said that even to the fourth generation,
yes,
of the old
Lord.
Covenant, that the sins of the father would be visited to that fourth generation. You declared that there would be no Moabite who could come into the house of the faithful for at least 10 generations.
Yes, Lord.
Ruth rose up and she broke that curse and she declared,
she declared to Naomi,
she said, listen, your God shall be my God and your people shall be my people.
Yes.
God, I decree now that whatever curses and whatever spiritual dysfunction, whatever spiritual legacies have negatively impacted
Be broken.
Family members,
he destroyed.
That bondage is broken now.
Yes.
And I decree that there will be a liberty and a deliverance.
Yes,
of the Holy
Lord.
Spirit. God, even those things that we were not aware of.
Yes.
God, relatives who dabbled in the occult.
Yes.
Those who walked in mysticism.
Yes.
Even those who dabbled in spiritualism.
Yes, God.
I decree that there will be a breaking of those curses.
Break it. Destroy it now, God, in the name of Jesus.
Spiritual influences.
Ah.
I also come against territorial spirits.
Yes, God.
Control areas.
Mandoros Bahai.
Certain areas to react in certain ways. I come against it now in the name
Now, God, in the name of Jesus.
I decree that no matter the territorial spirit, even as you sent Michael.
Yes, Lord.
Delivered unto him the message of power.
Yes, God.
That Daniel received.
Yes, Lord.
The prince of the angels that
yes, God.
War with the prince of Grecia and then with
yes.
the prince of Persia.
Yes.
I decree that there will be a deliverance from the power of territory.
Yes, God. Every territorial spirits and demons, oh God. Yes, God. Let there be deliverance from them now. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Walking in the unity of the faith, I come against that spirit. I come against that inequality. There will be a restoration in homes and families. Satan,
Jesus,
you hear my voice
Jesus,
as a prophet
Jesus.
Of God. I have power over you.
Jesus.
And I bind you. I curse you.
Yes.
The blood of Jesus
in the name
Christ
of Jesus. Yes.
And I decree that there will be a breaking.
A breaking.
A breaking of spiritual.
Breaking, God.
There will be a destruction.
Yes.
Of spiritual strongholds.
In the name of
Jesus.
Jesus.
That the actions of previous generations
will
not be allowed to keep us in spiritual bondage.
No, God. In the name of Jesus. We break every spiritual bondages in the name of Jesus.
And I decree that there is deliverance.
Yes, Lord.
Name.
Yes.
In Jesus'
in
name.
In Jesus' name.
That deliverance is complete. And that the
in Jesus' name. Deliverance be completed. And now God is gonna turn it around.
Cast down,
just got an encouraging word to share with you before I leave.
There are times
Lord,
don't understand, but I believe it's turning around for me. I've had struggles and disappointments. There are times I felt so alone. Some of my friends, they let me down, but I still believe it's turning around for me. Around for me. Around for me. Around for me. turning around for me.
Around for me.
Can you just say it into the atmosphere?
Around for me.
Around for me.
It's turning around.
It's turning around for me.
Somebody declare that. Declare it, declare it, declare it.
I can see the breaking.
I can see the breaking of them.
God is
making a way. A change is coming for me.
If I stay strong.
If I stay strong.
There's no reason
to doubt.
I know he's working it
out. He's working it out.
And it's turning around.
It's turning around for me.
This is the good news.
And it won't always be like this. Yes, somebody say.
He will perfect
what's concerning.
And
sooner or later, it'll work in your favor. Sooner or later, it'll work in your favor.
It's turning around.
It's turning around for me.
It won't always
be like this.
I promise you, I promise you, I prophesy to you, it won't always be like this.
Concerning me.
And sooner or later, it'll turn in your favor. Sooner or later, turn in your favor.
Just lift your hands to the atmosphere and claim your season of turnaround. Hallelujah. Now let's say this together. Come on.
Around for me.
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 It's turning around.
Around for me.
It's turning around.
just say that?
Sooner or later.
I know you can't see it right now. I know you can't understand it right now.
Sooner or later.
You gotta believe that all things work together for the good of them who, for the good of them who love me.
Hallelujah. Somebody says sooner or later. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Last night. Hallelujah. I love that. I love that, Jesus Child. Not later, but now. Not later, but now. Hallelujah. You know, last night the Lord gave me a word. So I want you to gather everyone as you can right now. If there's someone, if you're not at work, and you can call somebody and tell them to get online, get on board. Get somebody's attention right now, because I've got a word. Lord gave me this word last night while I was at work. And we're just talking and sharing with TK. I want to say blessings to my sidekick, TK. Amen. I had to go into Atlanta this morning, so she's not here with me, but I know she's here with me in spirit. And I just want to read for you. I want you to get somebody. I'm going to be reading a few passages of scriptures for you. Amen, somebody. But I want you to get somebody close, draw them close and tell them it's time for a word. Won't be long. Amen. I'm just going to probably introduce it to you and touch a few points and come back to it at a later time. But I believe it's with the prophetic atmosphere that God has created this morning. It's only fitting for God to release a prophetic word into the atmosphere. So I pray that everyone is tuned in and listening with a spiritual ear and eye. He that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord says. The book of Exodus, the book of emancipation, the book of Exodus chapter 3. And I'm going to read all the way through. And it says, now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian. And he led the flock to the back or west side of the wilderness and came to Horeb or Sinai, the mountain of God. The angel of the Lord appeared to him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. In other words, a burning bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, yet was not consumed. And Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush is not burned. And when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see, God called to him out of the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. And he said, here am I. There are times when the Lord will appear to you in many different ways and form. And when he appears to you, he wants to see if you're going to turn and give him your attention. The bush was burning. There was fire in the bush, but yet the bush was not consumed. And Moses understood that this is not natural. This is something supernatural. And I have to inquire. I have to see what's going on. God will visit us sometimes in such a supernatural way. Sometimes it could be through dreams and visions. It could be a billboard sign, a bumper sticker. It could be someone on the job. It could be an animal, your pet. It could be something unusual that he visits you. But he's trying to visit you to catch your attention. And you've got to discern what's happening. You've got to discern the time and the season and how God speaks and moves. So he caught Moses' attention. He said, here am I.
God said, do not come near. Put your shoes off your feet, for the place on which you stand is holy ground. Also, he said, I am the God of your father, the God of Abram, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look at God. And the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people who are in Egypt, and I've heard their cry because of their taskmasters and oppressors. For I know their sorrows and sufferings and trials, and I have come down to deliver them out. Somebody say out. Somebody open your mouth and say out. My God, you better get somebody in the chat room with you. Get somebody on board with you. Somebody say out. I will deliver them out of the hand and power of the Egyptians, and to bring them up out. Somebody say out of that land, to a land good and large, and a land flowing with milk and honey, a land of plenty, to the place of the Canaanite, the Hittite, the Amorite, the Perizzite, and the Hivites, and the Jebusites. Now behold, the cry of Israel, of the Israelites, has come up to me, and I have also seen how the Egyptians oppress them. Come now, therefore, and I will send you to Pharaoh, that you may bring forth my people, the Israelites, out. Somebody say out. Good God Almighty, somebody say out. Hallelujah. I will bring them out of Egypt. God said, I will surely be with you, and this shall be a sign to you that I have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you shall serve God on this mountain, Horeb or Sinai, the mountain of God. And Moses said to God, behold, when I come to the Israelites and say to them, the God of your fathers has sent me to you, and they say to me, what is his name? What shall I say to them? And God said to Moses, I am who I am, and what I am, and will be what I will be. And he said, you shall say this to the Israelite, I am has sent me to you. And if you're wondering, I'm reading from the Amplified Version. God said to also to Moses, this shall you say to the Israelites, the Lord, your God of your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever, and by this name I am to be remembered to all generation. Go gather the elders of Israel together, the mature teachers and tribal leaders, and say to them, the Lord God of your fathers, the God of Abram, of Isaac, and Jacob, appeared to me, saying, I have surely visited you and seen that which is done to you in Egypt, and I have declared that I will bring you up out of the affliction of Egypt to the land of the Canaanite, the Hittite, the Amorite, the Perizzite, the Hivite, and the Jebusite, to a land flowing with milk and honey. And the elders shall believe and obey your voice, and you shall go, you and the elders of Israel, to the king of Egypt, and you shall say to him, the Lord, the God of the Hebrews, has met with us, and now let us go, we beseech you, 3 days journey into the wilderness, that we may sacrifice to the Lord our God. And I know that the king of Egypt will not let you go unless forced to do so. No, not by a mighty hand. So I will stretch out my hand and smite Egypt with all my wonders, which I will do in it. And after that, he will let you go, and I will give this people favor and respect in the sight of the Egyptians. And it shall be that when you go, you shall not go empty-handed. Good God Almighty. Emphasis again on this part. Emphasis and out. Emphasis on this part right here. When you shall go, you shall not go empty-handed. Somebody say, I'm not going empty-handed. But every woman shall insistently solicit of her neighbor and of her that may be residing at her house jewels and articles of silver and gold and garments which you shall put on your sons and daughters, and you shall strip the Egyptians of the belongings due to you. Good God Almighty. I want to jump right quick to Exodus chapter 12. My God, I know I ain't going to have enough time, so I'm going to just introduce it. But I want to go to Exodus chapter 12 and around verse 30. Let me get there right quick. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God. I'm going to go to 31. He called for Moses and Aaron by night and said, rise up, get out from among my people, both you and the Israelites, and go serve the Lord as you said. Also take your flocks and your... Oh, Watch this. I want you to watch this. Go. This is Pharaoh now. Say, go. Take your flocks. Take your herds, as you have said, and be gone, and ask your God to bless me also. The Egyptians were urgent with the people to depart, that they might send them, hallelujah, they might send them out of the land in haste. For they said, we are all dead men. The people took their dough before it was leavened, their kneading bowls being bound up in their clothes and on their shoulder. The Israelites did according to the word of Moses, and they urgently asked of the Egyptian jewels, of silver and of gold and clothing. The Lord gave the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, so that they gave them what they asked, and they stripped the Egyptians of those things. The Israelites journeyed from Ramesses to Succoth, about 600,000 men on foot, besides women and children. Hallelujah. I'm going to stop right there. Last night the Lord shared a word with me. Hallelujah. Gave me a word. I was sitting down and I was wondering, okay, Lord, what am I going to say to your people today? Hallelujah. And the Lord gave me a word. He said, listen, tell my people I'm coming out, my God. Tell them to make a declaration. I want you to turn in the chat room, and I want you to type in the chat room. Put it on your Facebook. Put it on your status. Tweet. Put it on Twitter. Put it on Instagram. Wherever you got to put it. I want you to make a prophetic declaration and said, I'm coming out full. Hallelujah. The Lord wants me to inspire somebody today with this word, that make a declaration of faith to say, I'm coming out full. Glory be to God. As I've read for you through the book of Exodus from chapter 3 and on up to chapter 12, we understand that the children of Israel were in bondage for years under the harsh treatment of Pharaoh and the Egyptians. They were afflicted. The Bible also said that the more that the Egyptians afflicted them, the more they grew, the more they increased. May I encourage you today and tell you, sometimes you may be in a situation and you get afflicted, but the more you get afflicted, the more you should praise God. The more you get afflicted, the more you should worship God, because as you're being afflicted, your strength is being renewed, your faith is being built up. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Your endurance is being built up. Faith is being built up while you're being afflicted, because in your affliction, God is about to multiply and increase you through your afflictions. That's why the Bible said, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver them out of it all. The children of Israel were being afflicted by the hands of Pharaoh and the Egyptians. Watch this. As long as Israel remained in Egypt, they were unable to worship God the way he wanted them. God wanted them to go 3 days into the wilderness, allowing them to worship God outside the influence of Egypt, but Pharaoh would not allow it. Therefore, Egypt, hallelujah, can be seen to represent a religious bondage that prevents God's people from worshiping him. Let me say that one more time. Egypt in that time, hallelujah, hallelujah, were afflicting the people. Egypt in our time, hallelujah, our spiritual religious bondage, hallelujah, our sins that afflict us and keep us locked down and tied down in bondage. Some of us are filled with so much religious spirit. We are in religious bondage, hallelujah, and we can't worship God as we ought to worship him, because the Bible said God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. There's too much religiosity and there's no relationship. God is not looking for religion, but God is looking for relationship. God was not looking for religion out of the children of Israel, but God delivered them so they can go to Mount Sinai, the mountain of God, that they may sacrifice unto him, that they may worship him. So many of us are locked up in a spiritual bondage, but I declare and decree today that you're coming out, and you're not coming out empty, but you're coming out full. You're not coming out of your situation empty, but you're coming out full. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. The escape of the children of Israel from Egypt can also be an analogy of our escape from religious form, religious bondage. bondage into a true relationship with God. Just as the children of Israel were in a religious bondage to Egypt, many Christians today are in bondage to religious form and conformity of slavery. Most are not even aware of it. They're so blinded by it. This note, however, is not to address the issues faced by those in slavery to religious bondage. This note is to those who wish to escape from it. Hallelujah. So in other words, I'm not talking to everybody. I'm just talking to the few that are tired and sick and tired of being locked up in spiritual bondage. And it's about time for you to break out, break forth, break free. I dare somebody right now to declare, I'm breaking forth, I'm breaking out, and I'm breaking free from every spiritual bondage, every spiritual religious spirit that will hold me bound. According to Exodus 3 and 17, and I have said, I will bring you up out of. In other words, I'm coming out. Somebody better declare, I'm coming out. He said, I'll bring you up out of the affliction of Egypt unto the land of the Canaanites and the Hittites and the Amorites and the Perizzites and the Hivites and the Jebusites, unto a land flowing with milk and honey. God has a place prepared for you. God has a place prepared for you. So you can't make a permanent decision in this temporary condition you are in. Because if you don't know, Baba Sanda, if you don't know by now, God is getting ready. If you realize the things that are turning and happening in your life, God is fixing to turn some things around. He's shifting some things. He's putting some things in place. But all you've got to do is, like my son said a few Saturdays ago, just wait. Because if you wait, God is about to do something. While you're waiting, the all things are working together for your good. Somebody better shout, I'm coming out. I'm coming out. Repeated over and over again throughout the scripture is the principle of being called out. Even the word church comes from the Greek word ecclesia, which means the called out ones. Ah, somebody better help me. In this scripture, we find Abraham being called out of Ur, where he said, I want you to leave your kinfolks. God called out Abraham from Ur. Later on, the children of Israel were called out of Egypt, and then again out of Babylon. Oh, my Sunday. If you remember, they were also enslaved in Babylon. They were under Babylonian rulership and dictatorship. But there is a time coming. Oh, glory be to God. Where while you were in bondage, there's a time coming. There's a coming out time. And I declare by the Holy Spirit this morning that your days in bondage, your days in captivity, your days in Egypt are over. And you are coming out. Oh, my son. 1 Peter 2 verse 9 declares, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should shew forth the praises of him who had called you out of darkness and into his marvelous light. There are many of us that have been going through darkness, but I declare and decree to you, I prophesy to you in the atmosphere, that darkness has an expiration, and darkness must expire today, because your emancipation, your deliverance has come. You're coming out, but you're not coming out empty. You're coming out full. Hallelujah. Christians are called out with purpose, but we tend to lose sight of our purpose. Hallelujah. I want to declare to you and decree to you that change is in the air, and portions of your life that experience, hallelujah, bondage, that have experienced lack, that have experienced suffering, is no longer gonna experience it. Because as you were afflicted in Egypt, now you're about to come out, and you're about to get everything that was owed to you. You're about to get back the years that the locust and the caterpillar has stole. has eaten away. God is about to give you the unbelievable, the unthinkable. Oh my God, God is about to broaden and lengthen and expand and expand and expand. I hear God said an expansion is coming for somebody. I don't know who it is, but an expansion is coming for somebody, according to Isaiah 55 and verse 12. For you shall go out with joy and be led out with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break forth into singing before you, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. In other words, it's time for you to come out of your bondage, come out of sickness, come out of disease, come out of sin, come out of oppression, come out of depression. It's time for you. Your emancipation is here. Many of us are in mental bondage, but I hear Bob Marley have a song that says, emancipate yourself from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our mind. I hear the Lord said, my word has come to free you today out of the hand of the bondage of the Egyptians of our time, the bondage of oppression, the bondage of depression, the bondage of lack, the bondage of poverty, the bondage of sin, the bondage of loss, the bondage of infirmity, the bondage of marital abuse. Oh, my second, the bondage of religious spirit and religiosity. I hear the Spirit of the Lord said, my word has come to emancipate you, to set you free. And whom the Son sets free is free indeed. I declare to you today that you will no longer be in bondage. You will no longer be in captivity. Your freedom has come. Your emancipation has come. And I declare that you're coming out, but you're not coming out empty. You're coming out full. Give it back my joy. Give me back my peace. Give me back my anointing. Give me back my power. I've got power. Ah, there shall be glory after this. There shall be anointing after this. Oh, my say. Oh, God. Give me my marriage back. Give me my children back. Give me my finance back. Give me my ministry back. I want it all back. I'm coming out, but I'm not coming out empty. I'm coming out full. My God, the Lord said to tell you today, your seasons are changing. Your seasons are changing, and you're coming out full. Ah, somebody, oh my God, I ain't got time enough to go deeper in it. But I want you to prophetically make a declaration right now and say, Lord, according to your word, I receive it by faith. Moses was given a word to give to the children of Israel to say, listen, get yourself in order. Go borrow from the Egyptians everything, borrow from them, because your emancipation is here. Your coming out time has come, but you're not coming out empty handed. You're coming out full. So I want you to lift your hand right where you are and say, Lord, I received your word today. I receive your word today. And I prophetically declare that I'm coming out. I'm coming out full. Full of joy. Full of peace. Full of love. Full of forgiveness. Full of power. Full of anointing. But most of all, God, I'm coming out in a full-fledged relationship with you. I'm tired of religion. God wants relationship. So I thank you for my coming out. I thank God. Somebody better open your mouth and declare it today. I'm coming out. I'm coming out full. I'm coming out full. You're coming out full, Sister Sharon. You're coming out full, Sister Erica, Sister Terrianne, Jesus Child, Sister Yvonne, our waiters. You're coming out full. Everyone at the sound of my voice, you're coming out full. Seasons everywhere.
that I feel them.
Receive ye the word that God has spoken. No longer will you be in bondage and enslaved by the Babylonians or the Egyptians, but your emancipation, your freedom, your deliverance has come today, and you are free. Thank God you're free. No more chains holding you. You're free. In the name of Jesus, receive your freedom. Take your possession. Take your inheritance and walk into your purpose. Walk into your promise. The waiting is over. Walk. Walk into your season. Because you're coming out. Coming out full. You've survived the worst of times. God was always on your side. It's 12:07 p.m. Not out of word or song, but I'm out of time. Stake your claim. Write your name. Walk into Amasanda. You're coming out. Somebody say, I'm out. But I'm out full. May the Spirit of the Lord continue to rest, remain, and abide upon you, both now and forever. God bless you. I love you, family. Remember to join TK tomorrow, Turning Point Thursday. Remember to join DJ Penny Shabak Radio later as the revival continues. And I'll be back here, God's willing, on Friday. Island Worship Friday. Maybe the Spirit will lead me to go even more deeper into this. God just gave it to me last night, and I had to just put some things together. So you know when something is cooking, and you get a sniff, you get a taste, your senses of smelling kind of sniff the thing, and it say, something smell good in here, but it's not done cooking. So I gave you a sniff of what God has released. But it's gonna cook some more. Hey! So now you have an anticipation of a what it's gonna be like when it's finished. So I love you. I pray for you as you pray for me. God bless you and keep you. Cause His face to shine on you. Be gracious unto you and grant unto you His peace, His shalom, wholeness, completeness, nothing lacking, nothing missing from this time forth and even forevermore. God bless you. Love your family.
Whatever God promised,
whatever He promises,
He will never, never forget, no.
He will never, 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 never.
We're the seed of Abraham.
Oh, we're the seed of Abraham.
You can go on in and possess the land. It's yours, it's yours, it's yours,
it's yours, it's yours. It's yours. It's yours.